Someone has nothing to do with anybody politics or how they wipe their... It has a lot to do with how parents treat their children, how the educational system treats their children, how a culture treats its children. Right? That's what it has to do with. Okay. Can you tell me about the two discs? For example, pure gravitational thinking and hierarchical cosmology. What's wrong with it?
No, there's nothing wrong. It has all the content that you want to be on your website. You know?
Right. That's what I did when I was... I saw pure gravitational thinking and hierarchical cosmology in high school physics, all right, when I was 13, the first course in high school physics. That's when I saw it. Okay? So... That is the more developed from the point of view of physics. I know physics, I have a degree. That is a miracle. And it's on DVD. What is DVD 1? It was created on February 13, 2010.
Yeah, that's a long time ago.
Far,
5 years ago.
5 years ago. Far in excess. That will go unnoticed for 100 years, 200 years, all right?
Yeah.
Now that we know this, everything is pure gravitational, take a look at the resonance properties of the alpha lattice, all right, structure law 2, and the resonance properties that are built up in molecules, and what's the biggest molecule you know? The human brain. Are there gravitational resonance properties? When I get next to you, or you get next to your true love, or you're next to your family, all right, that you get along, that genetically you're compatible with, or friends, all right, or lovers, genetically, is there electromagnetic interaction when two people look in the eyes? No, it's just memories through sound and all the rest.
Yeah.
Gravitationally, is there interaction? Yes. Yes, it depends. Everything starts with the basic building block, which is the alpha lattice, which is the first Pythagorean solid, 386 BC. Right? So you build up the resonance properties until you arrive at the brain. All right. Everything I have said that I am doing, I am the father of the alpha lattice, I am the father of pure gravitational hierarchical, unified field structure and hierarchical cosmology. No one else is, not even Dion Chen or Hong Yang Chen from China and Korea. I did it, all right, from childhood. Secondly, there will be many PhD theses written, all right, on pure resonance and pure gravitational thinking, the human brain, resonance and pure gravitational thinking. There will be many, many, many. What David, the David Gross received his PhD under Jeffrey Chu, who I know, who censored me in 1977, all right? Whose theory of bootstrap theory, S matrix theory is crap, and the U.S. Congress paid for it, and they matriculated about 50 PhDs. It cost them back in 1970. It cost them millions and millions to do that. All right, and his theory is crap. Bootstrap theory has nothing to do with E equals mc squared or understanding the nuclear field, and it can be shown very clearly. All right, that's what the website will be. I mean, I'm sorry, Jeffrey Chu, who's still alive and in Berkeley.
Oh, he's still alive?
Oh, yes. Thank God. All right? And he should eat what he's dealt out.
You're getting pretty close.
And the top of the page reads, pure gravitational...
Elegant universe compared to your gravitational resonant thinking in hierarchical cosmology. This video begins with video of Green Van Sister, Fox News, Washington, D.C. with U.S. Senator John McCain on February 17, 2010, which is 4 days after Green Van Sister and U.S. Presidents Barack Obama have received your gravitational thinking in hierarchical cosmology on February 13, 2010. You should notice that there is no mention or recognition of any significant event having occurred, except a generational theft that is unconscionable. That is followed by Elegant Universal 1, Chapter 1, Einstein's Dream October 2003, worldwide.wjph/nova/elegantuniverse. In that historic video attached here, you are compared to a dog insofar as your ability to understand the new string theory of Brian Greene in with an NVGO mapping. In fact, a major event in the history of science, religion and cultures which had happened 4 days before the Van Sister, McCain February 17, 2010 video. That event was pure gravitational thinking in hierarchical cosmology on February 13, 2010. Keep that in mind, as this video oscillates between the video of Green Van Sister, Fox News, Washington, D.C. with U.S. Senator John McCain on February 17, 2010. Indeed, keep that in mind and the State of the Union, as we find it today, January 15, 2017, in the last days of stewardship of the Democrat presidency of Barack Obama and Vice President of Darkness, Joe Biden.
Tonight, Senator John McCain uncut and on the record. Senator, nice to see you, sir.
Thank you, Greta. Thanks for having me back. It's horrific. I think that this incredible deficit and debt is an active generational theft that is unconscionable. And, you know, somebody said the other day, active generational theft that is unconscionable.
What makes us think we can understand all the complexity of the universe, let alone reduce it to a single theory of everything? R mu nu minus a half, G mu nu R, remember how this goes, equals 8 pi G T mu nu. Comes from varying the Einstein-Hilbert action, we get the field equations, and this term, remember what this is called? No, that's the scalar curvature. This is the Ricci tensor. Have you been studying this all? No matter how hard you try, you can't teach physics to a dog. Their brains just aren't wired to grasp it. But what about us? How do we know that we're wired to comprehend the deepest laws of the universe? Well, this is today our confidence that we are. And we're picking up where Einstein left off in his quest for unification. Unification would be the formulation of a law that describes perhaps everything in the known universe from one single idea, one master equation. And we think that there might be this master equation. setting this alarm. What makes us think we can understand all the complexity of the universe, let alone reduce it to a single theory of everything?
R mu nu minus a half, g mu nu of r, remember how this goes, equals 8 pi g t mu nu. It comes from varying the Einstein-Hilbert action, we get the field equations, and this term, remember what this is called? No. That's the scalar curvature. This is the Ricci tensor. Have you been studying this all?
No matter how hard you try, you can't teach physics to a dog. Their brains just aren't wired to grasp.
Americans in recognizing what an immense feat this is. Because of what you have done, the heavens have become a part of man's work.
There's a ship lashing and ready in the harbor. Tomorrow for old England she sailed. Far away from your land of endless sunshine, to my land full of rainy skies and gales. And I shall be aboard that ship tomorrow, though my heart is full of tears at this farewell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell.
Go to GRAVITATIONAL.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GRAVITATIONAL.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two. GRAVITATIONAL.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two.
Would Albert Einstein plead for a vision that exhibits 1. Childlike curiosity and 2. Exhibits the symmetry in nature, and 3. Is the culmination of a child's visual thinking, whose audiometric analog is, unequivocally, the prelude to also Sprach Zarathustra, and is in fact the uncontestable physical theory of E pluribus unum. Would Albert Einstein express himself with great passion on the question of the making of a motion picture for children worldwide?
Well, I think the best way to explain what we physicists mean when we describe the universe as elegant is to reflect back on Einstein's relentless 30-year search for the so-called unified theory.
Finally tonight, a Gergen dialogue. David Gergen engages author and Columbia University physics and mathematics professor Brian Green. His new book is The Elegant Universe, Superstrings, Hidden Dimensions, and the Quest for the Ultimate Theory.
Brian, The Elegant Universe. Why do you and other physicists call the universe elegant?
Well, I think the best way to explain what we physicists mean when we describe the universe as elegant is to reflect back on Einstein's relentless 30-year search for the so-called unified theory. By unified theory, Einstein meant a theory founded on a few principles of such breadth and depth that effectively any question about the physical universe would be within the theory's ability to answer. For instance, the unified theory would describe the frantic dance of subatomic particles and the majestic swirl of heavenly galaxies using one single master idea, a master equation, so to speak. And that's where we see elegance, that the universe, although it's rich and wondrous, may be founded upon a few basic principles of incredible explanatory power. Now, Einstein never did find the unified theory he was searching for, but we believe that we may have it today.
Would Albert Einstein plead for a vision that exhibits, one, childlike curiosity, and, two, exhibits the symmetry in major, and, three, is the culmination of a child's visual thinking, whose audiometric analog is, unequivocally, the prelude to also Sprague's Zarathustra, and is in fact the incontestable physical theory of E. Pluribus Unum. Would Albert Einstein express himself with great passion on the question of the making of a motion picture for children worldwide?
We speak for Earth. We speak for Earth. Our loyalties are to the species and the planet. We speak for Earth. Our loyalties are to the species and the planet. We speak for Earth. We speak for Earth.
It is 6:35 p.m. on Wednesday, April 25. This is Observatory Place and Davis. This, presumably, is the government property and the residence of, the year is 2016, normal time, without time travel, that is, of Vice President Joe Biden, and it is also Observatory Row, Observatory Place, where Carl Sagan was with Jimmy Carter in December of 1977, when they sold out the people and children of the world, including the United States. This is now the residency of Vice President Joe Biden, who, according to a quick news report, he is Ash Wednesday Joe Biden, and you can see his picture days within, in 2010, of Valentine's, February 13, 2010, and he has an ash on his forehead, and he's with Barack Obama. He is Ash Wednesday Joe Biden, and you can see his picture days within, in 2010, of Valentine's, February 13, 2010, and he has an ash on his forehead, and he's with Barack Obama. And the point, one point being that there was a news report back around that time that Joe Biden, the Vice President, landed it at Santa Barbara Airport. He used the people's money to land at Santa Barbara Airport. It did not say for what, and it was a brief report. This is Timothy Victor Creer O'Boyle on this date, preparing to leave the United States of America, or let us say his country, in the country of Dr. Carl Sagan, who has a hypertesseract as a law of, basal law of nature, which means it is impossible, totally, absolutely, infinitely impossible to do pure gravitational thinking and hierarchical cosmology.
In discussing the large-scale structure of the cosmos, Astronomers sometimes say that space is curved, or that the universe is finite but unbounded. Whatever are they talking about? Let's imagine that we are perfectly flat. I mean absolutely flat. And that we live, appropriately enough, in a flatland. A land designed and named by Edwin Abbott, a Shakespearean scholar who lived in Victorian England. Everybody in flatland pie. But maybe more interesting is the other direction in dimensionality. What about the fourth dimension? Now, to approach that, let's consider a cube. We can imagine a cube in the following way. You take a line segment and move it at right angles to itself an equal length. That makes a square. Move that square an equal length at right angles to itself, and you have a cube. Now, this cube, we understand, casts a shadow. And that shadow, we recognize. It's, you know, ordinarily drawn in third grade classrooms as two squares with their vertices connected. Now, if we look at the shadow of a three-dimensional object in two dimensions, we see that, in this case, not all the lines appear equal. Not all the angles are right angles. The three-dimensional object has not been perfectly represented in its projection in two dimensions, but that's part of the cost of losing a dimension in the projection. Now, let's take this three-dimensional cube and project it, carry it through a fourth physical dimension. Not that way, not that way, not that way, but at right angles to those three directions. I can't show you what direction that is, but imagine that there is a fourth physical dimension. In that case, we would generate a four-dimensional hypercube, which is also called a tesseract. I cannot show you a tesseract because I and you are trapped in three dimensions. But what I can show you is the shadow in three dimensions of a four-dimensional hypercube or tesseract. This is it. And you can see it's two nested cubes, all the vertices connected by lines. And now the real tesseract in four dimensions would have all the lines of equal length and all the angles right angles. That's not what we see here, but that's the penalty of projection. So you see, while we cannot imagine the world of four dimensions, we can certainly think about it perfectly well.
This is Timothy Victor Creer O'Boyle on this date, preparing to leave the United States of America, or let us say his country, in the country of Dr. Carl Sagan, who has a hyper tesseract as a law of, basal law of nature, which means it is impossible, totally, absolutely, infinitely impossible to do pure gravitational thinking and hierarchical cosmology. We are down the street a little bit. There is a vice president's residency where Carl Sagan and Jimmy Carter met, Observatory Row. This is a measure of the rate of acceleration of this piece of wood. Is a measure of the field intensity per unit surface area in Structure Law 1, a pure gravitational unified field structure. If I were to hold the radius of the Earth constant and increase the density by 2, this piece of wood would accelerate twice as fast downward. That is according to Albert Einstein's gravitational treatment of the structure of the universe as a whole. Watch it. We'll do it again. except let's use a small chunk of wood. There is Joe Biden behind. You see it? You could put that in slow motion, and the fact is that, let's say, there are 3 billion children, 2 billion children on the face of the earth at this time. They can understand that very clearly, and the profoundly deep consequences it has in terms of pure gravitational thinking and hierarchical cosmology. Structure Law 1, Structure Law 2, the Alpha Lattice, my Alpha Lattice, not Carl Sagan's Hypertesseract, is inevitable and the only Structure Law that fits with Structure Law 1 infinitely perfectly. There it is. Unfortunately, I don't have an assistant to drop that block of wood. But Joe Biden is too busy flying around on the people's revenue or doing whatever he claims he does.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my needs. So I learned to depend on me. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadows. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I live as I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Inside, give them a sense
Our loyalties are to the species and the planet. We speak for Earth. Our loyalties are to the species and the planet. We speak for Earth. We speak for Earth. Our loyalties are to the species and the planet. We speak for Earth. We speak for Earth.
Go to GRAVITATIONAL RESONANT and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GRAVITATIONAL RESONANT and tell us what you think. We're back in two.
It's horrific. I think that this incredible deficit and debt is an active generational theft that is unconscionable.
Go to GRAVITATIONAL RESONANT and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GRAVITATIONAL RESONANT and tell us what you think. We're back in two.
ship lies rigged and ready in the harbor. Tomorrow for old England she sailed, far away from your land of endless sunshine, to my land full of rainy skies and gales. And I shall be aboard that ship tomorrow, though my heart is full of tears at this farewell. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word. For you are beautiful, and I have loved you dearly, more dearly than the spoken word can tell.
Go to GRAVITATIONAL and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GRAVITATIONAL and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GRAVITATIONAL and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GRAVITATIONAL and tell us what you think. We're back in two.
It's horrific. I think that this incredible deficit and debt is an act of generational theft that is unconscionable.
That's it. Why am I telling knock-knock jokes to Kim Kardashian?
Please turn off the president's mic. I think the president's mic is hot. Please turn it off. Thank you.
Great. I got to get warmed up. I'm so in love. God, I totally had that. Seriously, guys, what am I doing here? I'm the president of the United States, and I'm opening for Jimmy Kimmel? I have the nuclear codes. Why am I telling knock-knock jokes to Kim Kardashian? Why is she famous anyway? That's it. I have the nuclear codes. Why am I telling knock-knock jokes to Kim Kardashian? Why is she famous anyway? That's it. I have the nuclear codes.
It's horrific. I think that this incredible deficit and debt is an act of generational theft that is unconscionable. It's horrific. I think that this incredible deficit and debt is a act of generational theft that is unconscionable.
Go to GrowWire.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GrowWire.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GrowWire.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GrowWire.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two.
Is to work diligently to promote peace and progress, not only for ourselves, but for all mankind.
Go to GrowWire.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GrowWire.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two.
Film One has nothing to do with anybody politics or how they wipe their... It has a lot to do with how parents treat their children, how the educational system treats their children, how a culture treats its children. Right? That's what it has to do with. Okay. Tell me about the two discs, for example, pure gravitational thinking and hierarchical cosmology. What's wrong with it?
No, there's nothing wrong. This has all the content that you want to be on your website. You know?
Right. That's what I did when I saw pure gravitational thinking and hierarchical cosmology in high school physics, all right, when I was 13, the first course in high school physics. That's when I saw it. Okay, so that is the more developed from the point of view of physics. I know physics, I have a degree.
Yeah.
That is a miracle. And it's on DVD. What is DVD 1? It was created on February
13, 2010. Yeah, that's a long time ago.
5 years ago. Far in excess. That will go unnoticed for 100 years, 200 years, all right?
Yeah.
Now that we know there's everything is pure gravitational, take a look at the resonance properties of the alpha lattice, all right, structure law 2, and the resonance properties that are built up in molecules and what's the biggest molecule you know? The human brain.
Yeah.
Okay. Are there gravitational resonance properties? When I get next to you, or you get next to your true love, or you're next to your family, all right, that you get along, that genetically you're compatible with, or friends, all right, or lovers, genetically, is there electromagnetic interaction when two people look in the eyes? No, it's just memories through sound and all the rest.
Yeah.
Gravitationally, is there interaction? Yes. Yes. It depends. Everything starts with the basic building block, which is the alpha lattice, which is the first Pythagorean solid, 386 BC. Right? So you build up the resonance properties until you arrive at the brain. All right. Everything I have said that I am doing, I am the father of the alpha lattice. I am the father of pure gravitational hierarchical, unified field structure and hierarchical cosmology. No one else is, not even Dian Chen or Ong Yan Chen from China and Korea. I did it, all right, from childhood. Secondly, there will be many PhD theses written, all right, on pure resonance and pure gravitational thinking. The human brain, resonance, and pure gravitational thinking. There will be many, many, many. What David, the David Gross received his PhD under Jeffrey Chu, who I know, who censored me in 1977, all right? Whose theory of bootstrap theory, S-matrix theory, is crap. And the US Congress paid for it. And they matriculated about 50 PhDs. It cost them back in 1970. It cost them millions and millions to do that, all right? And his theory is crap. Bootstrap theory has nothing to do with E equals MC squared or understanding the nuclear field. And it can be shown very clearly, all right? That's what the website will be. I mean, I'm sorry, Jeffrey Chu, he's still alive and in Berkeley.
Professor,
oh yes, thank God. All right, and he should eat what he's dealt out.
You're getting pretty close.
And the top of the page reads: pure gravitational thinking and hierarchical cosmology is healthy for children beginning in kindergarten.
Go to GrabWire.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two. Go to GrabWire.com and tell us what you think. We're back in two.
I am pleased to award our nation's highest civilian honor, the Presidential Medal of Freedom. For the first and only time in my presidency, I will bestow this medal with an additional level of veneration, an honor my three most recent successors reserved for only three others, Pope John Paul II, President Ronald Reagan, and General Colin Powell. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to award the Presidential Medal of Freedom with distinction to my brother, Joseph Robinette Biden, Jr. Will the aide please read the citation?
Vice President Joseph R. Biden, Jr. In a career of public service spanning nearly half a century, Vice President Joseph R. Biden, Jr. has left his mark on almost every part of our nation, fighting for a stronger middle class, a fairer judicial system, and a smarter foreign policy, providing unyielding support for our troops, combating crime and violence against women, leading our quest to cure cancer, and safeguarding the landmark American Recovery and Reinvestment Act from corruption. With his charm, candor, unabashed optimism, and deep and abiding patriotism, Joe Biden has garnered the respect and esteem of colleagues of both parties and the friendship of people across the nation and around the world, while summoning the strength, faith, and grace to overcome great personal tragedy. This son of Scranton, Claymont, and Wilmington has become one of the most consequential vice presidents in American history, an accolade that nonetheless rests firmly behind his legacy as husband, father, and grandfather. A grateful nation thanks Vice President Joseph R. Biden, Jr. for his lifetime of service on behalf of the United States of America.
Every child on earth is entitled to know, one, that our sun is but one of many suns and stars, and that our earth orbits the sun in the gravitational field of the sun, two, that our sun is one star in a galaxy of stars, three, that the universe is infinite, an extension as a geometric hierarchy of galaxies, and four, that the universal law of gravitation extends infinitely far as 1/r². That a fine and wonderful man named Albert Einstein understood the 1/r² gravitational field with majestic perfection, but that he did not understand the structure of the universe in the large and in the microscopic structure of elementary particles, including the photons of light with which we see with five, that Albert Einstein's failure resulted because in his childhood the universe was deemed no bigger than the night sky of stars, which was not even viewed as a galaxy. Every child should know that the ability to see beyond Einstein results because we know today that the core of human consciousness develops from birth through 8 years old, and that our childhood realizations of the size and beauty of the universe determine the size and structure of reality for the rest of our lives. Every child should know not to cross into traffic and against the red light. Every child should know the golden rule and that the Ten Commandments of Moses is a sacred document that provides us with a moral compass with which to conduct our lives.
Thinking in hierarchical cosmology is healthy for children beginning in kindergarten.
You're getting pretty close.
And the top of the page reads, pure gravitational thinking in hierarchical cosmology is healthy for children beginning in kindergarten.
It's horrific. I think that this incredible deficit and debt is an act of generational theft that is unconscionable.
You're getting pretty close.
And the top of the page reads, pure gravitational thinking and hierarchical cosmology is healthy for children beginning in kindergarten.